I'm Claire, and I'm going to talk about numbers and counting. You'll need something to write on and something to write with. Post-it notes will be fine, but if you have any paper, that will be good. We've been learning a lot this week about numbers 1 to 100. Let's think about what we can learn today. Today, our learning intention is locating and positioning numbers on a number line. So we will learn to locate numbers on a number line using the number names, numerals, and representations. A number line can actually start at any number. So we will practice starting at different numbers. But the order on a number line really matters. So we'll talk about that today. But let's review what we've already learned. We have learned to count in ones, all the way to 100. We can count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 in ones. Or we can count in twos. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, 18, 20. We counted our shoes. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. Did you count your shoes at home? Do you have lots of shoes in your house as well? We also counted in tens. 10, 20. We thought that counting in tens is very handy, especially when you have a lot of things to count. We also learned to count in fives. Counting in fives can be great fun. Let's do these. 5, 10, 15. Very good. We also learned that sometimes you actually just know how many, and that's called, who remembers? That's right. Subitizing. And we had lots of practice of subitizing, and some of us made our own subitizing cards. Let's remember what these ones are. I bet you'll get these all right because I actually put them in order. Let's have a look. What's that? Excellent. You are doing so very well. Look at that. You can subitize very well. You can even subitize very big numbers. Did you subitize that one by going, there's a 3, there's another 3, and there's one in the middle? That makes how many? 7. Well done. And what about this one? What do you see here? Can you see a 3, a 2, and a 3? So that's 3, and 2 more is 5, and 3 more is 8. Well done. And what's this last one? Excellent. Did you see a 3, another 3, and another 3, and go, 3 and 3 is 6, and another 3 is 9. Super! These are all the things we learned in lesson 1, 2, 3, and 4. And if you didn't look at them, you might want to look at them now. After the lesson, some of you were going to make a Y chart with 50. Did you make your Y chart? Did it look like mine? Did you write the name of the number? The number is 50. 50. Did you write the number 50? And then did you do 50 dots? Did that take you a long time? Did you do yours like mine? 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30, 35, 40, 45, 50. Excellent. Do you know I can read this in another way? I read it to you in fives. But I can actually read it to you in tens because I know there's 10 in each one of those lines. So I could go 10, 20, 30, 40, 50. And you know 10 is my favorite number. So I can go 10, 20, 30, 40, 50. And I know there's 50 dots there. Y charts are very handy for learning the different ways to represent number. Today we're going to talk about number lines. Have you ever helped to hang out the washing? What did you need? Yes, of course you need a washing line. This is my washing line today. Do you like it? And you need pegs. I have got some washing pegs here in my basket. And we're going to talk about how you can use a number line. The first number I'm going to put on my number line is 0. 0, is that a number? It's a number that tells us where to start. We're starting with 0. And the last number I'm going to put on my number line is 10. Okay, so my number line is going to be a 0 to 10 number line. The next number I'm going to put on my number line is 5. But I need your help. Where will I put my 5? Will I put it here? Will all the numbers fit from 0 to 10 if I put 5 here? Did you say no? Do you think I should put it here? Will all the numbers from 0 to 5 fit in that little space there? Oh, you're right, they will not fit. Where will I put 5? Can you help me? Oh, who said in the middle? That's a good idea. Let me put the 5 in the middle. Is that the middle? I think it is. Let's try that. Let's put number 5 there. Okay, now, where am I going to put number 1? Do I put number 1 over here? No, of course not. You're so smart. Let me put number 1 next to the 0. Excellent. Shall I try number 9? Let me try number 9. Because I know, because you've been helpful, I know the 9 will go near to the 10. So let me put the 9 right beside the 10. So, what have I got on my number line? 0, 1, 5, 9, 10. Let me try another number. What number is that? 8. Very good. Let me see if I can put the number 8 on my number line in the right spot. Okay, what number do you think? 2? Where will I put my 2? Can you help me? Oh yes, good idea. I'll put it next to the 1. Now, I have 0, 1, 2. What number is coming up next? Oh, that's a 7. I thought it was going to be 3. Now I have to find where I put 7. Shall I put it here? Does 7 come before 5? What? It comes after 5. Oh, okay. So let me put the 7 right here. All right. Do you think there's enough space there? We'll see. Let's see. What number is next? Did you say 6? Yes, you're right. It is a 6. Let me see. Will I be able to squeeze it in here? Oh, I think I can. My number line, I might have to move things up just a tiny, tiny bit. Let me see. Can you see the number 7? Okay. Now, I've got 2 numbers left, a 4 and a 3. Do I put them there? Oh, the other way around, you say. Oh, yes. Okay, let me see. Here's 3, and here's 4. Did I fit my numbers on my number line? Oh, well, you can just about see the 7 there. Can you see the 7? Maybe I'll bring it to the front. Okay, there we go. Now, can we count the numbers on the number line? 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. You can make your own number line at home. You can use your post-it notes. You can write a different number on every post-it note from 0 to, what's the end in my, like my number line? It's number 10. 0 to 10. You might want to do that later, after this lesson. I'm going to ask you to help me again. I'm now going to try and do a number line, not from 0 to 10, but from 10 to 20. So I'm going to do a whole new number line from 10 to 20, and I'll need your help. So I'm going to take out the numbers that I don't need. Don't need any of those numbers. They can all fall down. But I do need number 10. I need number 10. Will I leave it here if I'm doing a number line 10 to 20? No. I will put it at the beginning, won't I? So here is number 10. My number line is going from 10 to 20. Now, what number will I try and put on next? Do you remember when we did 0 to 10, we put on the 0 and the 10. Now we're doing 10 to 20. What do you think we'll put on next? Yes, you're right. We'll put on the 20. So when you're making a number line, it's really good to do the first number and the last number so that you know where the spaces are in the middle. Now, the last time we put on a number 5. Do you remember we put number 5 in the middle? What number comes in the middle between number 10 and number 20? Are you thinking about that? What number is in the middle of a 10 and a 20? Excellent, it's 15. Let me put my 15 into the middle. Is that about the middle? I think it is. Let's put 15 in there. All right, now it should be so easy to put the rest of my numbers on. We can do just like we did before. Let's put in 10 and then 11 and then 12 and then 13. Are you helping me? 14. My 15 is already there, so let's go on to 16, 17, 18, 19, and 20 is already there. Can you see my number line? 10 to 20. Now I'm going to do something tricky. I'm going to turn over my numbers from my 0 to 10 number line, and I'm going to show you something pretty special. All right, let me show you something pretty special. Let me show you. We have to overlap them just like we did before. Here's the 0. The 0, can you see, is right underneath the 10. Because remember, when we did the 0 to 10 number line, we started with 0. When we did the 10 to 20 number line, we started with 10. And look at what is above the number 1. It's the 11. Can you see there's a 1 and there's 11? They're right above each other. Look what's underneath the number 12. It's the 2. And underneath the 13, we have a 3. Underneath the 14, we have a 4. Underneath the 15, we have a 5. 5 was in the middle of 0 to 10. Here we have a 6 and a 7 and an 8 underneath 18 and a 9 underneath 19. And we reuse the 10, so we don't have a 10 over there. But can you see how these numbers line up? Can you see that? It's very clever, isn't it? I do like that, because it does help you to see that 0 to 10 and 10 to 20 have a similar pattern. Can you see the number pattern there? We were able to see that number pattern in our number chart as well. Later today, I'd like you to have a go at making your own number line. All you need is a piece of string, your numbers written on sticky notes, and some clothes pegs. If you don't have any string, the great thing about your sticky notes is that you can pretend you have string and you can stick down your numbers on a table. I want you to have fun with number lines so that when I see you again, you will have done lots and lots of practice with putting numbers into the right order on a number line. I'd like you to have a go at making some number lines at home. All you need is a string and some pegs. But if you don't have those, you can use your post-it notes. The great thing about post-it notes is that you can stick them onto any surface. You can make your number line like mine. You could start with 0 and 10, and then, of course, you need to find the middle to put number 5. Then, of course, you have to figure out how close to the other numbers does the next number go. I have number 8 here. Do I have enough space for 9 if I put 8 here? I think I do. I'm going to find out when I'm finished, aren't I? So when you're at home, I'd like you to have a go at making a number line. You've worked really hard all week working with numbers from 1 to 100. You've counted in 2s and in 5s and in 10s. You've counted in 1s. You've counted forward. You've counted backwards. And we've learned to subitize and use number lines. Thank you for working so hard with me. I will see you next time. Bye.